And we now have on the line Health Undersecretary Maria Rosario Vergeire. Good afternoon, USEC, and thank you so much for taking our call.
Good afternoon, ma'am.
Can you give us an update, ma'am, on the meeting with the COVID vaccine developers, and what does it mean to consider VCO as an adjunctive therapy?
Well, it's adjunctive. It's supplementary to the treatment of COVID-19. As we all know right now, we still do not have any treatment with evidence that would say that can address COVID-19. So VCO right now is being tried as an adjunct. It is supplementary, and it is being given to our suspects and probable, and we are undergoing this clinical trial.
But how close is it to being a viable, even a supplementary therapy for COVID-19, as compared with the other possible vaccines that are being developed right now?
We have to be clear, no? VCO is not really something that can provide you with this immune response that vaccines can do. The VCO, as we have said, is an adjunctive therapy. It is supplementary. You give it because evidence shows right now, based from certain studies, that it has antiviral properties. So they are now giving it because it has also less adverse effects to the body because it's somehow natural. So that's why it is being tried, and people are saying right now, the scientists are saying that it has benefits. But of course, we still need to finish the trial so that we can have adequate conclusions for that.
And what kind of timeline are you looking at when it comes to the trials and checking the efficacy of virgin coconut oil, as even the drug, anti-flu drug Avigan?
Yes, for VCO, we started off last May in Santa Rosa Community Hospital, and it is supposed to be finished by December 31. So it's going to run for 8 months. Now for Avigan trial, we have not started yet. We are still finalizing various documents that are needed for us to be able to push forward or to move forward and start this trial. So we are still awaiting the clinical trial agreement and also the insurance policy that has to be signed. Also, we are awaiting the ethics review approval of the different hospitals that are going to be included in this Avigan trial.
Is there a coordination with the World Health Organization or any international organization on the trials, apart from, of course, the manufacturers?
When it comes to VCO and Avigan, of course, the different literatures and the different recommendations of WHO, the Department of Health always aligns with that and also has heeded the advice of WHO when it comes to this. We have joined two WHO solidarity trials for this. One is for the medicines where remdesivir is included. And the second trial would be for the vaccines, where we are trying to finalize agreements also right now.
What about the Russian drug? Are we in the middle already of trying those?
For this Russian vaccine, the Sputnik V, we are still negotiating. As we have said earlier, we have requested, no, the phase 1 and phase 2 clinical trial results of the Sputnik V vaccine, so that our vaccine expert panel may be able to evaluate it. And once their evaluation is done and they can say that it is okay, that we can go on to the clinical trial 3 here in the country, and then we are going to negotiate for that.
You mentioned insurance earlier. How can we ensure the safety of clinical trial participants?
Yes, this is part of the documents that has to be in order before we can start a clinical trial. There is this insurance policy so that there is safeguard for our participants if and when there are adverse events that will happen when they try out this drug. But of course, what would be most critical would be their informed consent, that they are informed of the advantages and also the disadvantages or the possible side effects of these medicines if they join the trial.
Meaning, how far does this insurance go, ma'am? Does this mean that in case of adverse events, such as their death, that there would be remuneration to their successors?
That I cannot disclose right now, but what I can say would be, if ever there would be adverse events, of course, government will be there to support if in case hospitalization would be needed.
Mm-hmm. Are we looking at other possible cures against COVID-19?
Well, right now, what we have right now would be the different medicines that we are trying out for the clinical trials. And of course, we're awaiting for the vaccines for this. Aside from that, we are continuously monitoring international evidences that might be issued so that we can also adopt it if it is feasible here in our country.
All right. Health Undersecretary Maria Rosario Vergeire, thank you so much for joining us today, ma'am. We appreciate the updates.
Thank you.